Hello, good morning to all once again. Hi, this is Purushottam Das Upadhyay along with my colleague Mr. Richie More. So please start the presentation for today. Hi, so welcome to this What's New SolidWorks 2021 segment 2. Why we say segment 2? Because of in earlier, if you have attended webinar, so in segment 1, we have covered SolidWorks User Interface 2021, SolidWorks part section, in the part modeling section, SolidWorks 2021, and e-drawing SolidWorks 2021. So in today's segment, basically we are going to cover SolidWorks assemblies 2021 and SolidWorks drawings 2021. So in today's agenda is these two things to cover. So let's start this one. Richie, please. Next slide.
Purushottam, you can control the slide, I believe.
Okay. So before we start this, just I would like to tell about corporate profile about Donix Technologies Private Limited. So we founded in 1996 and authorized reseller of SolidWorks since 1999. We have headquarters in Goregaon, Mumbai, branch office Thane, Mumbai. So along with SolidWorks, we have all other business alliances like AutoGrip. It is a very good solution for industrial vending solution. We have Simco, it is soft floor or manufacturing soft floor automation or Industry 4.0. And Envision Tech, it is metal 3D printing, and Pickup Mode, it is SLA or some plastic 3D printing. So these are business alliances along with SolidWorks we are having. So now who we are and what we do, Adonix Technologies, we handle both commercial and educational profile or portfolio for SolidWorks. So definitely we are providing design and automation solution to different verticals are there. We have more than 700 customer over here where we have implemented SolidWorks commercial version of SolidWorks portfolio, and all other engineering colleges where we have implemented SolidWorks educational bundle or educational solution to them. So we have 3D printing. In earlier slide, I have shown you that MakerBot and Envision Tech. We have AutoGrip. It is very good solution for industrial vending machine, provide point-to-point inventory management, how to manage all those inventory over there in your industry or in your organization. So that is very good solution we are having. And Industry 4.0 or soft floor manufacturing automation, it is Simco. It is well-known solution in the industry. It is CNC BMC automation solution, whatever or what any kind of CNC or BMC machine or automation machine, if you are having and if you want to connect with Industry 4.0 or if you want to capture all those manufacturing events over there, or even your machine efficiency, so whatever things you want to capture by using Simco, so that is very much possible. And it is definitely solution for 4.0 IoT, we say. So that is there in Simco. So this is like who we are and what we do. Okay, so we have very long-term relationship with SolidWorks Corporation India. So it is 21 years of partnership. It is very long association we have with SolidWorks Corporation India, and it is a very good milestone to achieve, and definitely we are growing strength to strength every year. As earlier I've told you that we have more than 700 commercial customer in Mumbai, Navi Mumbai, Thane, and all other nearby Mumbai areas. So definitely we have very good partnership with SolidBox Corporation India, and it is very good achievement, we can say. And when we talk about SolidBox ecosystem, so it is we have more than 5 million of SolidBox users. We have around of you can see that millions of our certified users. We have millions of Dropsite users. So Dropsite is dedicated for 2D users. If somebody wants to use only 2D, and if somebody if they are using any other 2D platform, and if they want to shift into SolidBox portfolio, so that is solution we have. It is Dropsite. We have more than 1.8 million of My SolidBox members. You all know that MySolidBox.com, it is credential-based website over there. There you can log in by using your credential, and you can find out a lot of things over there, like tutorial video or any resources or any query if you are having, or any error you are getting while you are using SolidBox. So you can find out, you can get solution over there in MySolidBox.com without waiting or without contacting to any other person. So directly you can get solution over there. Even you can connect with other SolidBox user also over there. We have, you can say that number of companies who are using SolidBox, they have more than 1.9 million 3D content central member, that is 3DCC. Again, it is very exciting platform over there, where you can go and you can download all standards component over there, all those 3D model or assembly directly you can go and you can download. If you are not manufacturing those standard components, if you want to use those standard components in your assembly, so don't have to create or don't have to design those things. Directly you can go into 3D Content Central. You can use a credential if you have created for mysolidbox.com. So same credential you can use for 3D Content Center, and you can download all those standard 3D model. Even you can share your 3D model also over there. So that is very good platform over there. We have more than 33,000 academic institute where we have implemented SolidBox education portfolio over there. Millions of Facebook fans, 800 plus Fab Lab. We have more than 600 software and hardware partners along with SolidBox portfolio. And we have more than 400 incubators and accelerators. So this is about SolidBox ecosystems. Now, in today's agenda is, like in earlier, I've told that even 25 years later, millions of passionate users, and here we are again showcasing another powerful release of SolidBox, like the rest of 2020. So this release is unlike any other we have ever had. So more than ever, it has become apparent that the future of design is collaboration. Definitely, we all are agreed about it, that future is design is collaboration. So what you are designing or doing, so definitely you want to collaborate. So that is a future of design. So in today's, definitely we are going to see only SolidBox desktop version, what's new 2021. But in coming webinar, we will see that how SolidBox and 3D experience platform have married to each other. So that definitely it is very exciting thing in upcoming webinar, you will see. But in today's presentation only, we are going to see desktop version of SolidBox 2021 and assembly and drawings. So in whole presentation, you will see the model or assembly we have used. It is tackling the inspection of dark and harsh sensitive environment is the speciality of Square robot. So whatever assembly in what's new section you will see, so that assembly we have used, that is Square robot system you're going to see. It is a startup based out of Boston, Massachusetts company. So they are using advanced submersible robotic lured into a petroleum storage tank. So they are like autonomously inspect these environments for defects in the storage vessels using update or state of the art or sensing technologies. So by being able to use robotic for this task, so they have reduced cost for their customers while improving accuracy. So their design is focused on the safety and reliability for these unique environments, providing maximum uptime and allowing inspection to take place when and where human would have to otherwise wait until the tank are empty. So founded in 2016, Square Robot choose Solidbox and Inovia. It is definitely its collaboration. We are going to see in upcoming webinar. So Inovia, Solidbox and Inovia, they have implemented and they are designing all these assembly and components and equipment by using Solidbox platform. So it was critical to them from the start to have the ability to work from anywhere, like combined with best in class design tools. So in that section, Inovia helped them to collaborate all the design team and all the design tools in a single platform. So this is all about the product we are going to use for what's new section. Now I'll invite to Richie for Solidbox 2021 assemblies and drawing what's new features. Over to you, Richie.
Thank you, Purushottam, for having a great head start to the product known as Square Robot. Now, in earlier webinar, we discussed or demonstrated about user experience and parts. Also, we did e-drawings. So in today's section, this is the second section of the What's New 2021 SolidWorks, where we'll be discussing about assembly productivity tools, assembly performance, and then we'll look at the drawing performance. So let's start with assemblies. So in assemblies, we have a lot of improvements and enhancements which will help you design and assemble your products, large assemblies, in a much faster manner. So the performance has improved up to 50% from the earlier 2020 version of SolidWorks. And we have more options, like we have slot mate defaults, we have spacing option for chain pattern, and so on. So let's dive in. So here we have a component from SolidWorks 2021, which is having So here you can see that whenever we want to do a mate, we simply select the faces and click on mate. Now, once the mate happens, you might notice in 2021 that all the standard mechanical advanced analysis sections are segregated on the top of the screen itself. You no longer have to scroll down the feature tree to find such options. So you can simply go on selecting standard, or you can go on advanced or mechanical and find the relevant mate types. So once you click on this kind of mates, it is very easy to find that in action. Now, whenever we do a mate, you might sometime find that the mate is not correct, and then you want to flip it. So once you click on flip mate alignment, there is a warning or a pop-up saying that it will cause mate errors. Do you want to change the mate alignment? So this is a good feature. However, sometimes it is not that user-friendly. So we'll undo that with Control Z. We'll go to settings in SolidWorks 2021. And now in the assemblies mate option, you can see that you can keep it as always, that change mate alignment on edit to be always, prompt or never. So what happens when you keep on always is, so whenever you want to flip a mate, it will no longer give you any warning. So it is that easy that it simply does it work because you want to do it, and it will not affect your other mates. Again, the second option is whenever you do a slot mate, you have the options to keep the component placed in the center to be in free or at a distance or percentage along the slot. Now in SolidWorks 2021, in the settings, you have default constraint for slot mates that you can keep it always in the center or always in the distance, a specific distance or a percentage. So that helps you creating slot mates very easily in the default constraint section. So here we have a pattern. It could be a sketch driven pattern or any pattern. Now this is a fastener which has a lot of configurations. You can see that now we can select the same configuration for all the pattern instances. Also, here we have an option wherein we can synchronize the configuration to the seed. So the orientation of the fastener of all the pattern components remains aligned exactly similar to the seed component. So it is very easy now that when you change any component, the other component configuration is also changed because it is in sync now. So here we can see that if we change the configuration now, all the configurations of all the pattern changes automatically. So this is a great feature for those who are doing fasteners. Another important option is interference detection. So most of the people do assemblies and then there is an interference detection, but they had to do it with looking at the SolidWorks screen. Now most of the people have a habit of having an Excel sheet with all the details of the assembly. Probably they want to calculate weight or probably they want to see whether there are interferences. Now SolidWorks 2021 has an option wherein you can save the interference detection results with the thumbnails of the interferences, and you can save it as an Excel sheet, and SolidWorks 2021 will capture all the interferences images as well and save it to the Excel sheet. So now let's open the Excel sheet. Here you can see that there are interferences in detail with the interferences preview. So it is very easy to highlight this to your team so that there is a change action happening on this assembly to get the assemblies resolved. Or probably you want to know which areas are the conflict areas which you want to solve it. So this is how we can export this as an interface. So again, whenever we open in a lightweight mode in SolidWorks, the assemblies open very quickly, right? So lightweight mode, the performance has improved. You can see that the component is opening in lightweight. And then it will update the assembly and it will update the graphics. So this is an assembly of a square robot, which we are using for 2021 of SolidWorks demonstration. So here you can see the folders. And here we have the lightweight components. Now, whenever you open a lightweight assembly tree, it automatically goes to resolved mode. This is very helpful wherein whenever we are opening the file in lightweight and you want to edit some properties, you don't have to make it resolved. It will automatically go to resolved state now. You can see the feather mark is disappearing automatically and it is converting into resolved mode. So here we have multiple configurations created in SolidWorks assembly. And in the assembly configurations, let's try to switch it to another configuration. So here there are no fasteners, here there are fasteners. So what we can do is we can set this to resolved. So right click and resolved. And in the performance evaluation, now SolidWorks 2021 gives you details of circular references. So here you can see that if there are circular references, it will show this in all the files which are having the circular references. Now just to denote that circular references takes a lot of time to load your SolidWorks assembly. So it is very helpful if you know that there is a reference entity of circular references in the assembly, which you can resolve it beforehand before saving the assembly. So here you can see that the references are here. We are going to isolate it. And then we are going to modify the holes and the positions if required. So here you can see we are modifying the external circular references and clicking OK. and let's exit out of the isolate option. So this is how we resolve the external references. Now the second option is, whenever you want to provide this assembly to some third party person and you don't want to provide the intellectual data, the intricate internal details, what you can do is you can give a defeatured configuration instead of the whole assembly. So what we are doing is we are adding the surfaces or faces to a group. So here you can see we are adding components one by one. We are adding it as a poly outline. We can enclose in one body and we can give the planes as well. We create a group and slowly you can see at the right hand side a nice preview appears for a defeatured component. So what we are doing is we are selecting the faces or the component from the left hand side main assembly and we are trying to create a dummy model which looks similar but not accurate. Why this is helpful is you can send the dummy component or dummy configuration to your vendor without having to disclose all the intricate internal details, so that the vendor can get the external dimensions required or maybe the fittings required or the clearance required. So in 2021 we can create a new configuration. You can see that we are creating a new configuration within the assembly itself, but again you can save it as a new document as well, which was a feature in 2020. So when you create a new configuration, now you can see that there is nothing as such in the tree, no features at all. So this is the default configuration which was used in the main assembly. So here you can see the main assembly is having all the details, but sometimes you want to avoid having all the components in the main assembly to save the load times. So what we can do is we can use the defeatured configuration which we saved earlier now, and once you use it, the defeatured assembly gets updated in the main assembly. So in fact you want to show just the preview of that component and not all the details must be loaded in the main assembly. So you can do this way, that you can use the defeatured component in the assembly. Now performance has improved in SolidWorks 2021. You can see that there is an option known as enhanced graphics performance. So whenever you go to SolidWorks and open to the settings, click on performance and click enhanced graphics performance, click OK, and you require a SolidWorks reboot. What I mean is you have to close SolidWorks, you have to open SolidWorks, and the option will be there permanent. That is, unless you untick it and uncheck it and remove the option, it will be always selected. So what happens is with this option, SolidWorks use most of the graphics resources. So here you can see on the left hand side, we have enabled the enhanced graphics performance. And on the right hand side, we have deselected the enhanced graphics performance. Now the version is SolidWorks 2021 and the machine is same. You can see a difference that whenever you want to rotate the component or revolve the component or zoom on the component, you can see that at the left hand side where the graphics performance boost is enabled, the same operation is completed in 7.94 seconds. And the frames per second is 63. So you get a crisp image and a faster image. But on the left hand side, even though it is the same machine and the same software, if you have unchecked the enhanced graphics performance, you could see a terrible loss of performance with 161.72 seconds to happen the same task. And the frames per second is 3.10. So you could see a choppy image whenever you want to rotate such large assemblies. So SolidWorks 2021 has this performance improvement for up to 50%, provided that you have to update your graphics card driver to the recommended one by SolidWorks RX settings. So again, here you can see the images are crisp, and also even with the hidden line visible option. So whenever you have made changes to the assembly and you make the visibility as wireframe instead of, or maybe hidden line visible instead of shaded with edges, you could observe, and you might be knowing that SolidWorks uses a lot of resources of your CPU. So now with this graphics performance boost enabled, you can see that most of the task is dedicated to the graphics card now. So even here, you can see that sometimes this happens, that even if you are in shaded with edges, sometimes some of the components go wireframe. So that will not be an issue once you turn on the graphics performance boost enabled. So you can see that it is very easy and a very fast way to visualize your large assemblies in SOLIDWORKS 2021 with graphics performance. So these are a few of the enhancements in assemblies, wherein you have the mate property management, then we have slot mate options, we have flip alignment options, we have assembly performance and circular references, and we have defeature capabilities. So the render pipeline is the one of the biggest improvement in SOLIDWORKS 2021, wherein even if you are working with large assemblies, your graphics card will be utilized most now instead of just using the CPU cores. So most of the work will be done by graphics card, provided that you have a dedicated supportable graphics card with a supportable driver installed on the system. So let's go to drawings now. So even we talked about SOLIDWORKS assemblies performance, the same goes for drawings. So most of the people, what they do is they have large assemblies, they create drawings with multiple sheets and multiple views, and then loading such drawings could take time, but not anymore with 2021. So let's look that in action. So here you can see we have the square robot drawing with multiple sheets. Here you can see that very easily you can zoom in and the images are very crisp. Earlier, we introduced detailing mode in SOLIDWORKS 2019. So in detailing mode, what happened was you could open the drawings very quickly, like in a fraction of seconds, without loading the models in the background. Now, it was limited only to detailing work. That is, you could add annotations, you can add balloons, you can add notes, and so on. So the enhanced graphics performance was in beta stage as earlier, but in 2021, it is available to the users to test it out in their regular day-to-day work. So here you can see that we are going to open the drawing. So this is the drawing opened in 2021 versus in the left-hand side, it is 2020. You could see that whenever we are, you know, just panning the drawing or probably zooming the drawing, it is laggy. But in 2021, the performance is very fast, just because that we have improved the enhanced graphics performance in SOLIDWORKS 2021, which uses most of the graphics card. So again, zooming in the components, you can see that there is less blur, the images are crisp, and you can work with ease, and the user is very happy because the software is very responsive now. So earlier it was very difficult to zoom in to the component, and then panning in and looking at the component properties, it was a little blurry. So this was a difficulty in 2020 in the detailing mode, but not anymore in 2021. So creating drawings of large assemblies is very easy now in 2021 of SOLIDWORKS. So again, going to the details, you could see that the performance is improved. So in the detailing mode, we have more options now. So earlier we could only do addition of balloons, addition of text, editing of notes, and so on, which was just like adding details to the existing SOLIDWORKS drawing. So it was like, you know, moving the magnetic line or probably editing the notes in the drawing, which was there till 2020 of SOLIDWORKS, or probably you can just delete some notes or something. But now in SOLIDWORKS 2021 detailing, you can do much more than that. So probably you want to add a break view, which was not possible till 2020 of SOLIDWORKS in detailing mode. Now it is possible. So you can select break view, you can select the extents where you want to break it, And you probably if you want to change the style of the brake, you can do that in the left hand side property window. So you can see that the properties can be changed. Also, you can add the dimensions, add to ordinate. So here you can see we are adding the dimensions. Ordinate dimensions are available in detailing mode as of now in 2021. And then probably want to have a detail view also. So this is a new feature now that in detailing mode also we can add detail views. So very easily we just select the detail view and it is added right in the drawing sheet. Also we can snap hole callouts in the detailing mode. So select the holes and it will give you all the properties of the holes. So it is a hole callout. So most of the properties can be arranged in the detailing mode. Also, sometimes you require tolerances. So with the existing dimensions, you can change the tolerances of the drawing. I think my screen just vanished. Okay, so going back to SolidWorks drawings, we have drawing performance improvement, we have detailing mode enhancements, we have quick relations and a lot of enhancement in SolidWorks drawings. So Purushottam, back to you. We spoke about assemblies and drawings. Now let's talk about promo.
Thank you, Richie, for showing the wonderful innovation and enhancement in SolidWorks assembly and drawing. My personal favorite is definitely in the assembly, if you ask, that is a switching configuration performance. It is absolutely, it is phenomenal. And in the drawing, it is detailing mode and performance. So whatever size of assembly you are opening in the drawing or multiple drawing seat, and if you are working on that, it is working very smooth. So that's great enhancement in SolidWorks assembly and drawing. So now comes to SolidWorks year-ending offer. It's currently going on. So promo offers for November 2020 and December 2020. It is buy two and get one absolutely at no cost. So that is the offer, buy two, get one, normally we say. So any of the two SolidWorks you can choose, and third one, or the same version or lower version you can get at no cost. So for that, we have terms and condition. Or for costing, you can contact to marketing@adonix.com or you can contact to Richie or me, there's no problem. So please to be continued for this or stay tuned for upcoming webinar. And we have scheduled 9th of December, 2020. 11 a.m. is the same time. And in the next segment, we are going to cover Visualize, SolidWorks Composer, SolidWorks Simulation, and PDM, that is Product Data Management. Or if time will permit, then definitely we can cover inspection and some other product also at the same time. And in the next to next, definitely we will announce at that day that what we are going to take in next segment and what is the product we are going to cover. So thank you for joining the webinar and stay tuned.
We'll wait for a few questions, if any, and then we'll close this webinar. So you can use the question and answer section. Okay, we cannot find any questions right now, but anyways, if you have any questions, you can always contact back to us at support@adonis.com and we'll get back to you with all the solutions and we'll resolve your queries. So thank you all for attending the session. And we hope that you attend the next section, that is Visualize Composer, Simulation, PDM, and probably if time permits, inspection also, and MBD on 9th of December, 2020. So thanks a lot. Have a great day.
Thank you to all.